Today, a lot of donations. Thank you. Trader Joe's here in Burlington. We've got about 3 carts full. The next will be a lot of lettuce that we donate to the Salvation Army. Incredible, isn't it? This is just one day out of 7 days that I pick up.
Hi, I'm Captain Scott Peavy of the Salvation Army of Chelsea, Massachusetts. Ruben Rodriguez has partnered with us here in Chelsea over the past number of years, helping out with distribution of bread and desserts and the feeding program that we provide here for the seniors, along with many other parts of the ministry that Salvation Army does here in Chelsea. His ministry is I believe, an important part within this community. As he continues to provide for those that are homeless, those that are struggling financially. He is showing a lot of godly love and compassion to individuals as in their time of crisis. As he speaks with them, you know, provides certain things for them, whether it be food or shelter locations and all of that. You know, Ruben is a great man of God, and I believe has made a great impact, not only being that beacon of light to those within this community, but being a brother in Christ and a partner as we continue together to reach out to those in need within this community of Chelsea. And so, you know, we're glad to have Ruben in that partnership with all of what we do here, and look forward to continued endeavors with him.
All right.
God bless you.
I seen a dude in your truck. Yeah.
Nice, huh?
Nice, sir.
Take care, brother.
We got some salad we're gonna take out of this one.
Go ahead and grab a bag and dump this in. This is some of our food that we stock up for the week. We'll take some of these TV dinners for people out in the street that we'll be feeding today. So we'll take some of these out.
Be content. Se contento. God is our Ebenezer. Up to this point, He's helped me to this very point.
Dios es nuestro Ebenezer. Nos ha ayudado hasta este punto y nos seguirá ayudando.
To bring the glory back into your life.
Praising the Lord Jesus Christ down here in Chelsea with the youth group from Hope Christian Church.
Carlos Mercer is the interpreter down at the church. And it's Carlos in the back. How you guys doing? God bless you.
God bless you guys.
So what's your name?
My name is Nock.
And how long have you lived here?
25 years.
How has Ruben's ministry helped you in the community?
Yeah, me a lot. Anytime he got anything, he called me and come over. Give me like, some clothes, some food, whatever, you know. Sometimes the homeless people, they need the food, and they need the place to sleep. You know what I'm saying? Chelsea, real bad. They're not good. You know what I'm saying? Rob people, stab people. Get the gun for the people's head, try to shoot them, you know. And I have my 3 kids, you know, I don't want to even have a children. Right now, I am a handicapped. In 2006, I got a car accident. I broke my back, my rib, my ankle.
Hi, my name is Steven. I'm a heroin addict. Been out here on these streets for 6-7 years, living out here. The reason I live out here is because I choose to. I have a wife, a beautiful home, kids who I can go to, but I choose to live out here in these circumstances. I shoot heroin every day, as much as I can. I've known Ruben for quite some time now. Ruben's organization has helped me. Ruben himself has helped me. took me to detoxes, tried to help me get my life together. You know, he's the church, he's always giving out food, helping out
people. Hey, how you doing, brother?
Giving out clothing. He's trying to start an organization out here, and we need as much as help as we can get. You know, out here there ain't no place where we can go and detox. We have to catch a bus and a train in order to be able to get to his place. In order for us to get better, we would need some help. Hopefully, you know, you guys can help our London here. Our circumstances out here is 2 blocks from here. It's right over there at the bridge, and that's where... That's down here is where we live at, and that's where we stay. We have no place to go, no place to hang out, no place to do nothing out here. If you can help out Ruben, he can continuously help us out. Because if it ain't for him, most of us won't even have the clothes we got on. You know, if it ain't for him, I wouldn't be eating right now. Thanks to him, you know, if anything, you know, can you please help us out? We really need it bad. Chelsea is really, really f***ing bad.
Thank you.
Thank you.
How you doing, man? Don't mind us. We won't videotape you. We're gonna videotape this way, all right? I'm trying to. I'm doing a fundraiser for my ministry, trying to help the people down here. Mark, right?
Tom.
I'm sorry, dude. Been a while since I seen you. You doing all right?
No.
All right. So don't mind us, all right? I come down here every now and then and just want to let the people know that there's a need for help. For these people that come down here, it's a well-known place for people to hang out. The police do come down here and take people away from here, but they seem to come back. As you look around, you can see that people are staying and living down here. They spend their time down here because there's nowhere to go sometimes. And we come down here to try to preach the gospel and to bring food and clothes and water and whatever they might need to help them. But as you can see, it needs to be cleaned up, and this is what my mission is, so I can start a drop-in center and one day a shelter where people don't have to live like this. And I just asked Jesus Christ to help me.
I'd go to a teaspoon of the max.
We're heading into
Boston where we go and help some alcoholics that they've been living homeless. One guy's been there 6 years. The rest, there's El Salvadorians, there's Hondurans, there's Americans, there's, it's a very sad sight. And we just go there and try to help build up their support ladder, see how we can help them with clothes, any resources that we have. But most of all, we like to preach the gospel to them. We come down here, try to come down here. Well, now we'll be coming down here Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, now that we have the truck. But it's only across the bridge from Chelsea. Sometimes, yeah, there's some people down here. They've been running him out of here.
So what's your name?
Rosemary.
And how long have you been in Chelsea?
58 years. I was born here in Chelsea. My whole life.
So how has Ruben and his ministry helped you?
It makes me feel not so depressed. Before I had problems being depressed and stuff. So it makes me feel good when I go there. I get excited every Saturday. I look forward to it.
How long have you been going to the church?
Maybe about a couple of years, maybe. Year and a half, 2 years, somewhere around there. You know, when we met up with Ruben, you know. And then we started going. Then we started meeting other people through the church and stuff.
Do you think it's helped you spiritually going there?
Yeah, yeah. Yes, it does. It makes, like I said, it makes me feel good. I look forward to it. When Friday comes, I look forward to it. Saturday. So Ruben picks me up because of my medical reasons. So he picks me up and my brother, and he brings us to the church every Saturday.
Anytime you need help, man. You know, and if you need like, you know, if it gets time you need clothes, I can hook you up with clothes, okay? All right?
We need some clothes.
All right.
Thank you.
God bless you guys. God bless you.
All right, I'm Steve Crowell here in Chelsea, Massachusetts. And just to talk a little bit about what the Lord's doing in this town. We've seen men and women really be touched by the Lord in this place. Really, we've seen drug addicts hear the word, come to the front, receive prayer, come to faith. We've seen drug addicts die. who had been to the outreach ministry on Saturday. But praise the Lord for the work he's doing in this community. And the need is great. The heroin plague is deep. Lots of drugs, homelessness, alcoholism, prostitution. But God will get glory in this community. The scripture says, has God not chosen the poor of this world to be rich in faith? Chelsea, poorest community in Massachusetts. Ruben's talked about a drop-in center, and because it's not a, as you know, dope fiends and drunks, one day a week, Sunday, church, whatever. And it's not going to do the deal. It's an everyday thing. We're not talking about any man getting honor or any organization getting honor. We're talking about the living Christ being glorified.
Yeah, my name is Dan, and we have a small Christian ministry here, faith ministry. We mainly give out the Word of God and counsel people and so forth like that. And on Fridays, we have a free outreach for people with low income. And so we get some stuff from our friend at the Anchor Baptist Church, and he drops it off, and we give out to people who fill out the forms that shows their low income. And so and this really helps out, you know, as a supplement. So we're glad to see this big guy show up, you know, once in a while, you know, when he feels like it. But anyway, you know, thank God. I pray for more food for the poor people here. You know, we give them the gospel. We give them a little gospel tract there about how to be saved by Jesus in Spanish, you know, and also in English, as most asked question.
My name is Jim. I've been going to Ruben's ministry now for about a year, and let me tell you, it's helped me quite a bit. You know, prior to being in Ruben's ministry, I never really went to church. You know, I went to church as a kid, going to catechisms on Sunday and so forth. But you know, as an adult, I never really was a church-going person. And since I've been going in Ruben's ministry, I've been going pretty much every week for about a year now, or every Saturday. And I even read the Bible a lot, which I never did before. Thanks to him, he's really showed me that that's what I needed to do in my life at the time, and that's still what I need to do. He's helped me a lot with food. There were times before when I didn't have any food in my fridge, and over the past year he's helped me quite a bit, as well as he's helped me quite a lot of other people.
How you doing? I'm sitting here with a friend of mine that I've known for about 2 years. Her name's Dominique. I'm just gonna ask her some questions about herself and what's been going on here in Chelsea. So Dominique, how long have you been out here in Chelsea?
I've been out here for about, a little over 10 years.
And what do you think Chelsea needs to help people that are in the streets of Chelsea?
A center that you're trying to make.
What kind of drugs do you see down in Chelsea?
What kind?
Yeah.
Every kind.
Like, for instance, what's your drug of choice?
Mine?
Yeah.
I smoke crack, but I was a heroin addict for about 13 years, so I got on the methadone clinic, and I guess I'm a little stressed out, so I can't feel the dope, so I'm moving to something else, which is coke.
And how has the ministry helped you out?
In a lot of ways. If I needed a ride to a program, a detox, Ruben's pretty much there for whatever I need, food, clothes.
And Chelsea doesn't seem to have anything like that, right?
Nothing.
Yeah, so, like I've given Dominique rides to detoxes and programs, and sometimes they don't have beds in these programs, so they stay out in the streets. So that's why we're trying to open up something where they can have, get out of the elements of nature, so they can come in and get something to eat, or something to just to read, or to take a shower, to eat. God's only son, perfect in spite.
behind me.